Hello and welcome back. I'm going to be quick about this one. It's 5 top tips for interceptor owners in less than 5 minutes. Let's go. Number 1. Lose weight. I don't mean you. You can keep eating pizza all you want. Any unnecessary parts of the bike that you don't like the look of, get them off of there. For me, it's the mudguard extenders, it's the grab rail at the back, it's the pillion foot pegs. All these little things help clean up the look of the bike and gives the bike a far more custom look without spending any money, and it takes hardly any time at all. With 47 horsepower, you've got a constant competition between power and weight. That little bit of weight you're losing might make a difference, or it might not, but the bike looks cleaner, it looks sleeker, and you haven't spent a penny. Number 2, side panel bags. These things are fantastic. I made a video about this. That video's got just over 4,000 views now, so many of you might have seen that and already know about these things. But I bought these bags online. They were not expensive. They cost about £60. I don't know how that translates to other money, but they look great and they give you a little bit of extra storage. One of the things I think Enfield could have styled better on this bike is the side panels. I think the Interceptor logo itself is kind of ugly, and I think these side panels should have been color coded. By adding the bags, we're hiding something that I don't think is fantastic on the bike and getting a little bit of storage as well. Number 3, and this one actually applies to many bikes. I am sick of hearing people saying that they cannot see anything but their shoulders on a motorbike. Word for word, it's what I hear out of people's mouths all the time. Post after post after post of people asking for recommendations for better mirrors. People buying mirror extenders, bar end mirrors. Just spend a bit of time, you will be able to adjust it. I am a fairly broad guy with pretty big shoulders, and I've got a perfect view. Top tip, move the stocks further away from you. With the mirrors further away, that widens the field of view, and you can then use the tilt and adjust to get the view just right. I'll be happy to place money on the fact that 95% of people can get a good rear view using the stock mirrors. Number 4, replace the left hand side panel bolt. The right hand side panel comes off with a turn of the key and a little wiggle and a jiggle, and then you get to the left hand one and you realise you've got to get the Allen keys out. If you're out on a ride and you don't have Allen keys, that's going to be frustrating. I discovered the bolt here is exactly the same size as a GoPro mounting bolt. So if you have a GoPro and a mounting set, go and grab one of your bolts and replace this. This allows you now to take the left hand panel off without having to grab the Allen keys. Number 5, clean your relays. The issue with starting, with idling, with running, there's loads of people had issues with the running of the Euro 5 bikes especially, and for most people it comes down to the relays. Replacing or cleaning the relays tends to solve that problem 9 times out of 10. And this isn't an issue that always crops up immediately. On my bike, it had about 300 or 400 miles on it before I started to notice this issue, and other people have reported it with far more miles as well. So it seems that it can kind of crop up at any time. So if you've not done so yet, get in behind the left hand side panel and clean out those relays. I wouldn't go ahead and replace them straight away. I've cleaned mine and everything is absolutely fine now. The problem here is a ton of white grease sprayed incredibly liberally all over the relays, so much so that it starts to interfere with the functionality of the relays. So if you haven't done so yet, clean those up. And that's it, 5 top tips for Interceptor owners in under 5 minutes, just as I promised. Now, I kept my promise, now you can do me a little favour. Please go ahead, check out my other videos, and please, if you like this video, hit like and hit subscribe. I've got lots more great videos coming in the future, and I'm excited to build this channel. Subscribing on YouTube is free, as you very well know. Thanks to the last few videos I've made, I'm now approaching that first milestone of 500 subscribers, so please help me get to that milestone and hit the subscribe button. Thank you, ride safe, and have a great day.